What's up, everybody? Welcome to my channel. Welcome to all the new subscribers. Welcome back to the old subscribers. I am doing some April energy still. I'm on the sign of Leo. There is one more day left for my $20 special for all my readings. So if you guys would like a reading, email me. Take advantage of it if you so desire. I appreciate all the likes, the love, the comments. I don't want any negativity on my page, so your comments will probably be deleted as well as you. Okay. Hope everyone's having a good day. Let's see what the messages are for the sign of Leo for April 2018. When I was shuffling, the Three of Swords in reverse came out, and as well as the Justice card. So maybe there is an apology for some of you from someone. Maybe there was a wrong choice made, but it's going to be evened out, so there's going to be some clarity coming with that. Could be a rebirth, or maybe just finally realizing the truth about something for some of you. The bottom of the deck is the High Priestess in reverse, so this feeling like someone has a hidden agenda, or there's just something that you don't know, but you can kind of like, you know, like you feel it, but your intuition is blocked to what it actually is, and you don't have clarity about what the truth is. Then you have the Strength card. So it's kind of, you know, realizing you do have the strength inside of you or for the situation to kind of get through whatever there's going on. It's all about taking control and having the confidence, because it's like good things, you know. Then you have the King of Swords, so thinking about exactly what it is you want to do and going to do it, because the King of Swords is very on purpose. Like, they know what they want, they go get it, they've thought about it long enough. Everything they do is on purpose, like I said. Then to the table you have the Queen of Wands in reverse. So maybe not knowing what you want, maybe not feeling up to, you know, not really feeling yourself or having the self-confidence. You're just like, meh, you know, kind of this insecurity or just feeling really angry about something. And then the Three of Pentacles in reverse just came out. So maybe this person that didn't work with you, you know, you don't have, you're just like, well, I don't know what they want, and I don't really know what I want anymore either, you know, because then you have the Three of Swords. So there is this heartbreak or this loss or depression here, dealing with someone who, with the Nine of Cups in reverse, was probably, you know, promiscuous. Just like not there emotionally for you, or maybe just not happy, you know. Maybe that's just how you feel now that your heart is broken from this person. You know, the Three of Swords is a communicated message, so you are going to be getting a message, or you already got the message. The next line you have the Knight of Swords in reverse. So this asshole ping pong in and out, don't know what they want, just really immature and impulsive. Then the Page of Cups in reverse. So there again, immaturity, codependency, just childlike, you know, with how they speak. But then you have the Six of Cups. So reminiscing a little bit, you know, there is some growth in maybe your feelings or the situation. You're just thinking about, you know, the good times. Or, you know, maybe it's something to do with your family, you know, because the Page of Cups is usually a younger sign. But there is a lot of immaturity here with this person. And it's because they're not in their highest power. They're on a lower vibration in the reverse. Why is this Page of Cups in reverse? So, like, a message of wanting to start something new. Maybe they're thinking about you. Maybe they were immature in the past, and now they're coming back, you know, so you're just not really sure how to take that at this point. What is the Six of Cups here for? Yeah, still this energy of not knowing what they wanted in the past. Someone who's really overbearing, like, not ready for a relationship, but then still sending a message, like, what is that, you know? Like, I feel like the energy is just all over the place. What's the Page of Wands here for? Seven of Swords in reverse. So there was some betrayal. There was, you know, the cheating, lying, stealing. I feel like this person knows that they were caught, and they... Maybe this, the Page of Wands is them trying to make things better, but they're still not in the right place, you know, to offer something because of the situation. The last line you have is the Page of Swords. So, you know, kind of spying a little bit. This is like gossip. This is, you know... people just kind of in your business. And because you have so many pages, this is all really immature energy, you know. Then you have the Emperor. So this person who is pretty stuck in their ways, but they're still like structured. They're still, you know, all about leadership and action and determination. Or maybe it's just about you coming up with this plan for your life. You kind of like stepping in that role. Or it could be an Aries or a Taurus for some of you with the Three of Wands. So waiting, I think, for, you know, looking ahead to the situation, but just kind of waiting. Maybe this fire sign is kind of waiting for you. Or you're just at this point where you're kind of hopeful and waiting, trying to, for them to kind of, you know, see how this plays out. What's the Emperor card here for? With the Four of Cups. So, still kind of disconnected. There's a lot of emotional disconnect. Even though four is like a stable level, I feel like the adversity comes after that and then it's growth. So, there's still a lot of growing up to do here. What is the Three of Wands here for? The Moon card. So not really knowing, you know, not really seeing some things. And you just kind of feel like, well, is this an illusion? Or is this just a problem? Or is this just something I'm not sure about right now? You know, it could be you wanting to change directions in your life. Like waiting for the right thing to come in, you know? Because then there is this person that's coming in really fast to offer you, you know, a new start. I'm passionate, you know, and you've got a lot of fire energy here. You do have air. Yeah, I see a lot of fire and air and then a few water, but I feel like it's a fire sign for you guys majorly. Or maybe this is just your energy, you wanting to go try something else because in the past you didn't know what you wanted. So... you know, you're just kind of trying to figure it all out, even though you're kind of disconnected, or this other person is. You know, because there is forgiveness and moving on here with the Five of Cups in reverse. You're trying to forgive something. You're trying to recover from everything so that you can move forward. For some of you, it could have been having to do with your family with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Family conflicts, you know, money problems, just lack of stability in general. So it's left you kind of in your head, like thinking about everything, like, you know, a lot of grief and anxiety. And then you have the Nine of Wands. So it's about keeping the right boundaries with people, having this resilience to kind of figure out which way that you do want to go. Because Nine is the fruition stage. And then you have the Ace of Wands. So this new start is here for some of you, you know, wanting to do this. Let's see what the healing cards are for the situation. What are the healing cards for the Sun of Leo for April 2018? What are the healing cards for the sign of Leo? Okay. You have beauty. Remembering that you are beautiful. Even though you don't feel like it sometimes. Then you have help from above. So you are being assisted by your angels, by your guides. Just remembering that you are being helped. Then this alchemy of knowing that you can manifest whatever it is that you want for your life. And then unleashing your creativity to do whatever it is that you want to do. Letting it out. Going to do what you want. You know, not for anybody else, for yourself. Let's see what your guys' energy cards are. I mean, the fact that the Three of Swords came out in reverse and then the Three of Swords upright came out in the reading, I think that there will be an apology. So if there's someone that did break your heart, there's going to be an apology coming in. What are the energy cards? Okay. Some of you need some help with your second chakra, Archangel Ariel, because it's in the reverse. Also with your first chakra from Archangel Michael is in the reverse as well. So that's something to be aware of. You have man holding a coin in reverse. So this could either be, maybe there was someone that you relied on financially, or maybe there's someone who used you for money. You know, that's a factor here. Then you have the thinking man in reverse. So someone's not thinking, you know, clearly or correctly. Then you have attachment in reverse. So maybe trying not to be coming out of this attachment that you had to someone, maybe. Then you have woman holding a heart in reverse. So maybe just not wanting to give your heart away right now because everything is so crazy, you know? Let's see what your affirmations are because I think they're important. So for the man holding a coin, the affirmation is, I determine my own destiny, I take financial action, and I am receiving wonderful assistance from those around me. And then for the woman holding a heart, you have, I am emotionally calm and peaceful, and I attract healthy and stable people to me. Thinking man in reverse is, I am willing to learn new things. It is safe and comfortable for me to open up and share. And then attachment. Your affirmation is, I release attachment and choose peace. I am strong, free, and able to choose what honors me. And then for your first chakra, Archangel Michael. Your affirmation is, my first chakra is open to its perfect healthy state. I am strong, stable, safe, and secure. The Archangel Michael guides and supports me always. You guys got some heavy shit going on. Woo! Maybe just knowing that you're coming out of the attachment to the wrong people. That recognizing that it's time to let some good people in your life instead of being dragged down. You know? Maybe some people don't deserve you. What are the romance angel oracle cards for the sign of Leo? What are the romance angel oracle cards for the sign of Leo? Of April 2018. Okay, your romance angel oracle cards are give your relationship a chance, work on your partnership, because you guys do have new love here. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. Then you have playfulness. I'm sorry, this lighting is fucked. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. And then you have this could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. So those are all the messages that I have for Leo. So everyone have a good day.